giving you all the glory and honor and praise. As we begin to draw nigh to you, as we begin to worship, opening our eyes, open our ears, where we can hear, as we humble to the anointing of the Holy Ghost and fire. My spirit is calling. Come to my presence. Thank you.
Santo Dio,
We have all this time. ourselves as a living sacrifice before the living God. We come bold into the throne of God's grace, hallelujah, that we can find time and the help of our need. God, that you can give us that grace this night, that we can enter into your kingdom and enter into your divine life of your Holy Spirit, hallelujah, the anointing of the living God. We have taken time to pray, we've taken time to seek your face. We're taking time to draw nigh to you with all of our hearts and all of our mind and soul. We have come into this house, hallelujah. We have dedicated our temples, our bodies, which is the temple of the living God, for you. Say in your word that you do not dwell in temples made by man's hands, but you dwell in temples that are not made with hands. And that is our body, is the temple of the living God. We are a sanctuary. And we're sanctifying our spirits. We're going to sanctify our souls. We're going to sanctify our physical bodies for you. We're going to quicken our mortal body by the Holy Spirit. We're coming boldly and healing our hearts, our minds, our souls, our thoughts. And we bring everything into captivity. Every weakness and every fear and every worry, we surrender. And your mercy, hallelujah. Thank you.
Thank you.
As we consecrate ourselves this time, we open our hearts to the living God, and we welcome His Holy Spirit to come down from heaven and come and touch us, come and wash. Open our eyes, so that we might see the anointing of God, so that we would see what you see, so we can abide and dwell where you dwell, that you're going to come and dwell within us as we yield to you. And we surrender our spirit, soul, and body to you, Lord God. We pray for a Holy Ghost breakthrough in our hearts and our minds. us have, so that we can declare as He is in this world, so shall we be also. And that self-same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, let that same Spirit now resurrect us into the very life of Jesus Christ. The anointing of the living God, that you release your glorious presence, that you begin to manifest yourself. Break every yoke and break every sickness and break every disease and break every concept of traditions of men and every kind of doctrine that comes from the cunning craftiness of men that comes from the natural man. We want the living manifestation of the divine nature of God to come alive within our hearts, so you can give birth to this life and you can take charge of our lives, that you can purify us, that we can be led by the Spirit, and that we can be crucified with Jesus Christ, and nevertheless we shall live. Hallelujah. But it won't be us no longer living, because we want your life to live in us. worship and praise you, Lord, and be our Messiah.
This is my soul.
Thank you.
creating us a new heart and a new mind. Give birth to your love in our spirit. Let that love grow, take over our soul and our mind and our thoughts. Let that same love come alive in us as we surrender to that love. That the precious blood of Jesus will then wash away all the hurts and the pains and the memories. You wash our wounds, the things that we have been afflicted in this world, oh God. Memories of the sufferings, memories of the pains and the hurts that we just completely washed away. You wash away the very consciousness of the iniquity and our sins through the offering of the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. You purify our spirit, soul, and body through the offering of Jesus Christ. As we humble ourselves and humble our flesh, and that we yield to your spirit and take on the very mind of Christ that is in the Holy Ghost, that you will now take over our lives as we surrender. Let all old things pass away and all things become new. As we put off the old nature, we take on the new one. And we become partakers of the divine nature of God through Jesus Christ. And you fill us with your glory. Hallelujah. We bring into your glorious relationship in the Holy Ghost and fire. And we ask you now in Jesus' name that you open the heavens now. Open the heavens over this city. We stand in the gap and make up the hedge. We plead the cause of the people that are bound by sin and the darkness of this world that are bound by iniquities and sins, offenses, hatred, and jealousy of God. People that are bound by the very strongholds of guilt and condemnation. Those that need to be set free from drugs and alcohol, from a sinful way of living in unclean spirits, oh God, that we will now lift up these prayers on the behalf of our city, that our city would be saved, oh God. That through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ, through the offering of your life, that when you die on the cross, that through that power, when you lay down and you condemn the sin in the flesh, so that when you die you sin, so that we could be saved. Because you became a sin for us who do no sin, so that you can then create us and give birth to a new life in Christ that's going to come alive inside of us. Hallelujah. And our hearts and minds will be transformed as we renew ourselves and learn to grow in the Holy Spirit and the Word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, we lift up the souls of men, women, and children. We stand in the gap and we command all the principalities and power that has them in captivity to darkness, that you will open their eyes and wake them up in their hearts and minds and cause them to realize they don't have to live under the control of the darkness of this world. And we take on the image and likeness of Christ, which is in the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Oh, we take on the very new nature of the living God and come alive. Hallelujah. Release your glorious manifestation of your power and let us break through into the power of the living God. Let us be transformed into the very likeness of Christ as He is, so that we can become like Him in this world. Because you're going to let His Spirit live inside of us, and we're going to humble our natural man to submit to His Spirit who's inside of us. That we love you, Father, and we submit to you with everything in our hearts. We make you our Lord and our God and our Savior and our Deliverer, our Healer, our Provider. You are in charge of our lives, and we dedicate ourselves to the most holy God. Hallelujah. We surrender, we yield to you this night. We come this night to pray. We come this night to yield to you. We're coming here tonight to consecrate ourselves to you. We're going to lay aside, forget those things that are behind. We're going to press for the things that you have for us in your love. Holy God Almighty, how wonderful you are. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we're going to yield to your love. Yield to your peace. And we're going to yield to your faith. Hallelujah. We're going to yield to your righteousness and your grace and your mercy. We yield to the forgiveness that is in your name. We yield to you, to the divine intervention of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We yield to the life of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Son of the living God. We yield to our Heavenly Father. We yield to the Almighty God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We yield to your life right now. I yield to you. Oh. we surrender all our weaknesses. We surrender every evil thought and imaginations. We surrender any critical attitudes in our hearts and minds. We surrender all doubts and unbelief that may be in our hearts. Hallelujah. We surrender any temptation that tries to defile us with the unclean thoughts and imaginations. We surrender the very life of Jesus Christ into our hearts. We yield to that Spirit of Christ so that you can come alive in us. We surrender our lives to your Spirit. We break every stronghold. We break every guilt and condemnation. We surrender it all to Jesus and lay it on the altar of Jesus Christ, the sacrifice Lamb. You're my Savior. You're my Lord. You're my everything. And I yield to your life. I surrender my life. I give myself to you. I yield to your everlasting life. Come and make your abode within my heart. Come, let your spirit live within us, O Lord, so that we can serve and that we can place our total trust and dependence on your anointing and power. For without you, we are nothing. Without your anointing, we are lost. Without your spirit, we're empty and dry. But then we can do all things through Christ as we dedicate ourselves this night. As you pour out your spirit, as you pour out your anointing, fill every one of us this night, even the ones that's going to watch us on YouTube. Fill every person today. Begin to take the time to pray and seek your face and draw nigh to the glory of God, to the living life of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, who is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Holy Father. Hallelujah. This night I'm opening my heavens and I'm releasing my spirit and I'm coming down to you as you open your heart and yield to me. I am releasing my anointing and my power. I'm giving birth to my love, to my truth, and my faith. I shall quicken you this time. My spirit shall take over your spirit, soul, and body as you yield to me and humble to my spirit that I can lead you and guide you. I can teach you by my spirit. I can begin to manifest myself to your earthen vessels, that my spirit will take charge of your life as I become the head of your life. I become the one that has the authority, the head of my church, the living church, of the living God that's born of my spirit, not of the will of man, nor of the will of the flesh, but by my spirit. This night I'm releasing my holiness, my very holy presence, as you surrender and enter into total consecration, dedication of yourself to my life that is in the anointing in the Spirit of God, so that the old things will pass away and all things become new. Myself within your heart and mind, and I will take you into the depths of my everlasting love, and I will come alive in you as you humble to me and yield to me and obey me. Obey me, my commandment. My commandment is not grievous, to love God with all your heart, to love God with all your soul, to love God with all your mind and all your thoughts. Let my love abide and dwell in you. As I dwell in you, you shall dwell in me. As my words abide in you, then I shall come alive in you. As you wait on my leadership, as you wait on my Holy Spirit, I will then speak to your hearts. I will teach you, I will open my word to you, the hidden things of my word will come alive. I will show you things that people have not seen yet. I will reveal to you the greatness of my life that gives you power, that gives you authority over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means harm you. You will be anointed as my Spirit begins to anoint you to heal the broken hearts, to bring deliverance to the captives, setting the captives free by my Spirit, by my anointing, healing the sick and raising the dead and quickening every heart and mind. Hallelujah, I am releasing my end time anointing into this world that's going to shake this very cores of this world. I will not allow the enemy to destroy the souls of the people of this nation and the nations of the world, for I shall fight their battles. I will come and rescue their souls. I will deliver them by my offering of my Son, Jesus Christ, and I shall break every yoke and bondage that they're bound in, and break every tradition and bondage that man has created by the imagination of their own hearts, and I shall bring them into a true relationship where they're going to rest in my presence, rest in my glorious life of the Holy Ghost and fire, and men shall know.
Thank you.
shall not have dominion over you. For you're no longer under the law, but under the grace of God. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made you free from the law of sin and death. For Jesus has condemned the sin in the flesh, so that the righteousness of the law shall be fulfilled in you who walk not after the flesh, but those who walk after the Spirit. The law of the Spirit of life that is in Christ Jesus. It is my life, the Christ life, that makes you holy. It is the anointing that makes you holy. It's the resurrection life of Jesus Christ that makes you a new creation, where I have created my Spirit within your heart, and I'm taking you into the depths of my glory, into my faith, into my life. Everything that I am is in the anointing. Hallelujah. For it is my Spirit that shall come alive in you and make you who you are in me, as you yield my love, as you yield to my mercy, as you yield to my understanding and my revelation knowledge. And I shall open your understanding in the Spirit, not in the flesh, not in your carnal minds, but in your spiritual mind that is within you. And then you bring your spirit and your soul in complete body, total surrender to the Spirit of God. You bring your flesh and your carnal thoughts completely yielding on the mind of Jesus.